both these sides in Group B, as India, who lost their opening match, take on Uzbekistan at the Ahmed bin Ali Stadium in Al Rayyan. It's match 16 of the AFC Asian Cup Qatar 2023. Well, Australia beat Syria earlier to book their place in the knockout round. A win for either here leaves them in with a better than good chance of joining them, even as one of the best third place teams. This group could go right down to the wire. Just a single goal enough for Australia earlier on to win that match. Well, this magnificent stadium, one of the venues that was built for the 2022 World Cup and used for the Arab Cup in 2021. Is the host to tonight's game. Fantastic atmosphere. Russia rise alongside me. And looking forward to this one, because we know it is a must-win game for both these teams.
I most certainly am looking forward to this fixture between these two sides. India coming into this off the back of that defeat to Australia on match day one. Incredible atmosphere here in this ground. Mostly Indian fans looking to support their team against higher-ranked opposition once more. For Uzbekistan, to me, a frustrating draw against Syria in the opening match. Their own players admitted that. Masharipov coming out and saying they have to do better in this match. Perhaps a few nerves in their opening game against Syria. Well, the hope for them is that they'll have shaken those nerves off as they come up against an Indian side who you'd expect to be putting 100%. Igor Stimac said 120% up against them in this game. We're set for a good game of football, I would think, and a fascinating one tactically here, Mark.
Well, both these sides dropped a couple of places in the recent FIFA rankings. India down to 105. Uzbekistan 69th, so a lot higher ranked than India. And this is officially the toughest group in this competition based on the average FIFA rankings. Of course, Australia are 25. So when you look at those numbers, this is the toughest group in terms of the ranking points that both these teams have got. Sunil Chhetri, such a wonderful servant for India, the second oldest player to be playing in this tournament. And he was the second, or the oldest player rather, to take the field in the first game since 2004. Hard to believe he's 39 years of age and still going strong. And he could have been a completely different story had he headed that early goal. He had a great chance early on in that opening game against Australia, but he headed wide.
Yeah, he didn't have too many chances in that match against Australia. They were really focused, India, on making sure they were compact and secure defensively and looking to try and make things difficult for Australia, which they did, especially through those central areas. Australia having to go out wide and use the crosses, use the width. Eventually a mistake there, really causing the pain for India. And once Australia got the goal, they just went on and took even more control of that match. But you're right to mention, when they do get the opportunities, which will be few and far between, they have to take them against such high-quality opposition that they'll be coming up against in this competition.
Yeah, Uzbekistan making their eighth appearance in the finals. Their best was a fourth-place finish back in 2011. They've reached the quarterfinals, they've reached the round of 16 4 years ago. And they will be tough to crack tonight for this Indian side. We will have the national anthems. It'll be the Indian anthem, followed by that of Uzbekistan.
Uzbekistan.
Learn from Suresh. Just have him in the midfield there, alongside Abuya. Do all that running in those central midfield positions. Just have a look at how they set up in possession here. You've got the three in there with Gurpreet right at the base of their build-up play. Two central defenders in front of him, splitting left and right. And then you have Abuya and Suresh just behind that first line of Uzbekistan pressure.
India are missing a key player at the moment in Sahal, who was injured towards the end of the Indian Super League season before the break for his club Mohun Bagan. He normally partners Ali Rutapa in that holding role, and they've been so effective for their side this season. But Sahal is in the squad, but still not deemed fit enough to start, although he is training. Here come Uzbekistan. Bit of space here for Nazruliyev, looking to take on Nikhil Pujari. Crosses in towards Gurpreet, who came and didn't claim. And the flag stays down, and Uzbekistan have scored. Fazuliyev gets the opening goal. The man coming into the starting lineup, one of three changes, and the 20-year-old, one of the youngest in the squad, gets his third international goal, and India find themselves trailing once again.
Well, a bit of a surprise that he didn't start the opening match, but he starts now. He's learned his lesson, Uzbekistan's coach, starting with that quality of Fazuliyev. Great anticipation from the young man. And the first real opportunity that they actually have here, it's Fazuliyev who gets the move going in that attacking midfield space, and quick to bounce on that. A little bit of ball watching from that Indian defense, from that Indian back line, not tracking the movement of Fazuliyev. Sandesh Jingan is focused on the cross that has come in, and Fazuliyev is there. It's a very cool header past the goalkeeper, Gurpreet.
I'm sure Igor Stimac will see that as a very soft goal to concede so early on in the match. Inside 5 minutes. Fazuliyev, who scored against Kyrgyz Republic on Christmas Day in a friendly. Uzbekistan, who made the round of 16 5 years ago. They drew with 0-0 with Australia before losing out on penalties. If they do win here, they put them onto 4 points. That could well be enough, even as a third-place team, to go through from the group.
Now you just have a look at Sunil Chhetri, just chasing from the front there, looking to apply that pressure. Lovely switch up. And Uzbekistan will be a lot more relaxed now, having gotten an opening goal.
Well, Masharipov playing it forward to Fazuliyev, who was clipped by Suresh Wangjam, who is a real energetic box-to-box midfielder. Suresh Wangjam, he's the real engine. Always covers plenty of ground and has some of the best distance numbers during the league season. Just caught Fazuliyev, the goal scorer. And a free kick in a dangerous position here, and more organisational work in front of him to do here for Gurpreet. Shukrov and Masharipov are over the ball. There are four white shirts inside the penalty area. Four more waiting to come from deep. The stadium is still filling up, so one or two people who were late arrivals would have missed that first goal. We are now ready for the free kick, I think. The referee's happy. Shukrov whips it in. Good header away by Sunil Chhetri, who was in front of his goalkeeper.
That's that noise every time Chhetri gets involved. His introduction as well was greeted by a wall of noise here.
Yeah, it's hard to believe when you think he still plays with the enthusiasm of a teenager, even though he is 39. As we say, the other player that's 39, and this is a goalkeeper, so doesn't have to excel the same kind of energy levels that Sunil Chhetri does. Remarkable the way that he's kept himself fit over the years. But he, like his teammates, have now got to step up their game an extra 10% because they trail by that early goal from Fazuliyev. Here's Eshmudarov. A lot of these players in the Uzbekistan side play for Paktakor in Tashkent, so they will be familiar with each other's playing styles and know where each other is instinctively. That's a lovely ball over the top again for Masharipov, trying to get him behind Nikhil Pujari. Pajari did well enough though, just got a foot in, but Uzbekistan swarming over that second ball at the moment. Shukrov. A bit of space here for Husanov, who fires it goalwards, the centre-back. But he's a long way over the top, hasn't scored an international goal. Had a good sight there, but he was a long, long way out.
Yeah, not a good decision to have a shot there from well out. Smarter choice would have been a simple pass out wide. But they are looking very comfortable now, stroking the ball around. Good movement off the ball as well. You can see them exchanging positions. Just have a look at Shkurov. He's dropping out to this left-hand side, and then he'll swap roles with, or swap positions rather, with Masharipov at times. The number 7 and the number 9 of Uzbekistan, Kamrobekov as well. So important in how they play, the ability to get in between the lines of the opposition.
Lovely footwork from Masharipov to get away from Nikhil Pajari. Here come Uzbekistan again. Lovely ball play through. Good save, Gurpuri. One of the tallest goalkeepers in the competition, and he was at full stretch there to turn that one away. But once again, Uzbekistan playing simple football to create the openings. Nazruliyev trying to turn away from Mahesh. Oh, that's a heavy challenge from Nikhil Pajari. We heard that one from up here. Real crunch as he hit the ankle. Here's the chance though.
Yeah, good move from Uzbekistan, right down the middle. Good pace of play as well. Fayzuliyev, I think when that shot was actually taken, he was in an offside position. Flag stayed down, and out of it, they've gotten a free kick here. Now challenge from Pajari. He was well late.
Yeah, you're right, he should have been given us an offside when Fayzuliyev gathered that ball off the glove of Gurpuri. Did score the goal, but he took a real hefty whack on his ankle then from Nikhil Pajari. Here's the goal again. Simple movement, just got away from Sandesh Jingan on the blind side. And there was no blame really attached to Gurpuri, who just came out and tried to put him off. But Fayzuliyev was brave, knowing that the goalkeeper was coming.
And Shukurov there beating the first ball that was played in, winning the first header. Playing it into the path of Fayzuliyev. And it's a nice composed touch. You see players in those situations, they take their eye off the ball when they see the goalkeeper coming out. No issue for Fayzuliyev.
Ball whipped in again off the bar from Masharipov. Well, Gurpuri was only a yard or so off his line, but such was the quality in the delivery that evaded his arm. Came back off the bar, but the pressure's still on from Uzbekistan, and it really is backs against the wall for India in the early stages here.
And this is a really crucial period of the game for India here. Uzbekistan look up for it, buoyed by that early goal. See that confidence really flowing through the side. India have to somehow find a way to ride this out, to hold firm here. Perhaps need to just sit back a little bit more, try and close the spaces. Masharipov with that delivery into the area. I wonder if he intends to do that. It looks like it. With the body shape and the whip that he put in on that, Masharipov. He's another one who's so difficult for the opposition defence to pick up. Drifts across the forward line. Moves into some really dangerous areas.
He's one of the players that plays his club football outside Uzbekistan. He's with Greece with Panathinaikos. It's all Uzbekistan at the moment. Masharipov, man who hit the bar a moment or so ago. Good challenge that time from Naren Mahesh. Now India will stride forward here with Akash Mishra, who was caught, was he, by Sifiev? The referee, I think, will pull that back. He's only given the throw.
Looked like a foul to me.
Well, he was certainly in full flight, Akash Mishra. He did get injured in training the other day in a challenge with his home player, Naren Mahesh. But he's fit enough to start, but that looked quite a heavy knock that he took, and an uncomfortable-looking fall again from Akash Mishra, who is the youngest player in the Indian squad.
Now you can see quite clearly on that replay, got to the ball ahead of the challenge from Sefiev that came in. It was a late challenge. I think the referee perhaps just thinking from his perspective that maybe Akash Mishra could have stayed up, tried to keep the ball in play.
He's the second youngest player, Akash Mishra, rather, not the youngest. Vikram Pratap, who's not playing today, who celebrated his 22nd birthday 2 days ago. He's the youngest, one of the uncapped players that came into this tournament. India played with Deepak Tangri in that midfield role at the weekend, but it was a more defensive midfield for Igor Stimac in that opening game against Australia. When you consider India 105 in the world, Australia at 25, it's very difficult to set up. They frustrated Australia for a half an hour or so in that game. It's clumsy for Rav Beke, who didn't get the ball away. Chingana Rahul just eventually coming away with the ball. This is Anirudh Thapa. Now Manveer Singh. Is this the first chance India have got to mount a meaningful attack? Well read and well covered by Eshmudarov.
That was actually a clever bit of play. Good run from Manveer down the right-hand side. Clever pass from Anirudh Thapa into Manveer. Just needed a better touch, a tighter touch in that situation. Try and cut out these individual mistakes at the back, India. Also, we saw Akash Mishra just getting caught underneath the flight of that ball.
Well, India were so close to going into the round of 16 in the UAE. They beat Thailand in their opening game. They conceded. They were 0-0 with Bahrain. The point would have taken them through as a third-place team, but a 91st-minute penalty denied them a point after Bahrain won by a single goal. We've got two balls on the pitch here. The referee says play on. Nazruliyev. Asharipov. Already showing what a tricky player he can be, but well, that's a wayward shot. Having hit the bar just a moment or so ago, that's a complete opposite.
Yeah, no control on that effort from Asharipov. But what he does is he just uses the run of Fazuliev as a decoy. Took a defender away from him, created that space on the inside for Asharipov to carry the ball into. Well, you can absolutely understand India's approach against Australia. Gulf in quality, gulf in class between the two nations. But it never really gave them, never set themselves up for an opportunity to try and really challenge Australia, to put Australia under pressure. I think there is a bit more of a chance of them doing that here against Uzbekistan.
Yeah, had such a successful season up until the latter part of 2023. They lost out to Malaysia in the semi-finals of the Merdeka Cup, beat Kuwait in their first World Cup qualifier before losing 3-0 to Qatar up in Bhubaneswar. Igor Stimac has just signed a new two-year extension to his contract with the option of a further year if he can get them through to third round World Cup qualifying. They play Pakistan next month. Interestingly, Ashley Westwood, who's the Pakistan coach, has flown in to watch the match today to do a little bit of scouting, the former Bengaluru coach. It's away by Pujari. Flipped off by Sergeyev. Nicely won back, Sunil Chetri. No need to tell you when he's on the ball. The crowd will do that for me. Is Manveer.
I like how they won that back, India. They just closed down and squeezed the space in midfield. They work together. Closing down together is going to be so important today. Work as a team. Need to have players offering themselves as options as well for their teammates in possession. If they're looking to try and build, can't be too far apart. Try and make sure that compactness is there when they do have the ball as well. Otherwise, on the transition, Uzbekistan will hurt them.
Stabbed off by Apuya. Akash Mishra just got the ball under his feet. Just about to get a little bit of an edge on Sofia on that far side.
Strong play from Kusanov as well, covering for his fullback, Safiev.
Suresh. Sandesh Jingan. Manveer didn't get the touch on that. Was just trying to guide that to Nikhil Pujari, who was outside him, but not great execution. Rahul Beke caught in possession by Fazuliev. Here goes the youngster again. He's got Sergeyev racing into the middle as well. Great ball across. Well, it's turned against his own bar, put in by Sergeyev. And Uzbekistan have scored again, but it comes from a clumsy mistake by India, who've given the ball away on the halfway line. It could easily have been an own goal. Suresh put the ball against his own post or crossbar, not sure which, but he came back out. Nobody reacting quicker than Sergeyev, who put the ball into the empty net. And Uzbekistan lead 2-0 here, early stages of this Group B match.
Looking great for Uzbekistan. not very good for India. And then once more, it's an individual error, this time from Rahul Peke. Just gives it away. So clumsy in possession. Heavy touch, gets it taken away from him. A pass forward perhaps would have been the better option in that situation, or tighter first touch. They try their best to clear the line. Akash Mishra almost scoring an own goal. Comes off the frame of the goal. And credit to Uzbekistan and to Sergeyev following up to put that away. And how about that? The two changes in attack, Sergeyev and Faizullaev, coming up big for Uzbekistan with the goals.
Well, you can see what it meant to Igor Sergeyev. Plays for BG Pattam United in Thailand. Goal number 20 in Uzbekistan colours as well, and an important goal because, as we said, a win today would probably put them through to the next stage of the competition. But Igor Stimac, not the start he would have wanted. Took them a long time, Australia, to break down the Indians in the first game, but this new, slightly different attacking style from India today has probably played into Uzbekistan's hands a little. They've capitalised on a couple of errors by India.
Right, look at the first goal, I think, just switching off at the back, not challenging. With the cross that was played in, the first header was won by Shukurov. He was pretty much unmarked, and then Faizullaev just drifting away from his marker as well. A bit of ball watching, a bit of naivety from that Indian defence. And then with the second goal, an individual error, Uzbekistan, you know, at this level, make mistakes like that, and when you play against these higher quality sides, they tend to punish you.
Manveer with a quick throw, Sunil Chetri, Anirudh Thapa, Manveer bursts into the box, cleared away by Ishmudarov, but the flag's up for offside. It wouldn't have counted had they managed to create anything. India only had 29% possession in that first game, four shots, one on target. Three of those shots came from outside the box. They were struggling to break down Australia and create anything through midfield inside that penalty area.
Yeah, they offered very little in the way of ball distribution in the final third. Almost nothing in the final half hour of that match against Australia. Just one defensive line break in the whole game. And just 10 receptions in the final third. Against Australia, who, if you want to talk about the difference in quality, they managed 212 of them. Such was the dominance of that Australian side.
Once again, it's Budarov that gets that ball away. And goal scoring has been an inherent problem for India, really, over the years, with the exception of Sunil Chetri. In the second round of qualifying for the last World Cup, they only scored six goals in their eight matches. They qualified for the third round of qualification by finishing behind Qatar and Oman. But then they did fare slightly better in the centralised games in the third round of the Salt Lake in Kolkata, winning all three. The highlight was a 4-0 win over Hong Kong. And since then, the goals have started to slip away from them once more. Suresh, Jingan, Pujari, Manveer being tightly marked by Nazrulayev. He's come away with the ball here though, Nikhil Pujari. Sunil Chetri trying to bring that down under control. It just squirmed away from him slightly.
Well, that was much better from Manveer. He's made some pretty good movements, but the first couple of times, the first touch hasn't been good enough. Just there, he was able to hang on to it. Play back for Pujari to try and create an opportunity for India.
41 goals now, by the way, in 16 games. Saw our first red card last night as well. Amadoni Kamalov for Tajikistan. There's Sunil Chetri, stabbed away again by Ismudarov. Better from India, just starting to come into the game a little bit more now. Pujari. Can't get the height on the ball into the box. Apoya, heavy touch, just allowed the ball to run away from him. It's Faizullaev that makes the challenge. Pujari couldn't quite get there before Nazrulayev, and Uzbekistan will bring the ball away, but Suresh will win the free kick, far by Misharipov. But there's a little bit more purpose about India's play going forward now.
That was a fantastic bit of defending from Suresh as well, just coming across, using his strength, showing his physicality. That was brilliant, stopping a potential counter-attack. But India, with that move that they had just then, sort of build it through midfield, nice link up between Apuya and Suresh, and then Tapa playing in that half space, able to receive and turn away from Uzbekistan's midfield line very well.
Let's give it away. And a Tapa drives the ball across, no one attacking it through the middle. Sunil Chetri was at the front post. Mambi was just a little bit on his heels. It was hammered across by Eni Rutapa in the hope of getting a touch off anybody, really. Mistake by the goalkeeper, Yusupov.
That's really good pressing, really good pressing. Now, gambling is not something I recommend at all, but on the pitch, if you're a striker, you need to be gambling in those situations that the ball's going to be coming right across. Manfir perhaps has caught on his heel slightly.
Uzbekistan have had a good year, 2023. They're currently unbeaten in their last six internationals. You just said their coach there, Srećko Katanić, not happy that his side are giving the ball away in the final third. Came into this with a friendly win over Kyrgyz Republic on Christmas Day. 4-1 as well. A really good result for them. Fazuliyev was on the mark in that game, scored the first goal for them. Two World Cup qualifiers recently. They beat Turkmenistan and drew 2-2 with Iran, which is another creditable result against the powerful Iranians. It's Nazruliyev.
Well, it was a nice little spell of possession there for India. It was a couple of worries for Katanić, who had to move into his technical area, try and wake his players back up. They don't want to lose control of this Uzbekistan. They don't want to give India any opportunities to get themselves back into this match.
Just helped on by Shukrov. Sefia. Nine of this Uzbekistan squad play outside the country. In Russia, Belarus, Bulgaria. Nice movement again. Fazuliyev getting in behind the Indian defence once more. In the middle. Hooked away by Akash Mishra. In India throw, it goes out of Ishmudarov.
Lovely work from Uzbekistan on this left-hand side. Fazuliyev and a link up with Masharipov. Absolutely brilliant. Sergeyev as well, just dropping off that forward line to touch it into the part of Fazuliyev. Carved their way right through that Indian defence. Just couldn't quite get themselves into the box quick enough after that move.
Yeah, they play very simple football, Uzbekistan. They find players in pockets of space. We saw it from Jordan against Malaysia a few nights ago. Just keeping it simple, not complicating the game, finding players in space and using excellent movements. And it's the old adage in football, sometimes it's not what you do with the ball, it's when you haven't got the ball.
Well, that off-the-ball movement is so important. The players providing, offering support, offering options. They say getting in between the lines of the opposition tactical shape. And it's incredibly difficult, almost impossible to defend those third-man runs and the quick passing game. If you're playing one touch, you can't get to it quick enough as a defender. It's always going to go quicker than you can respond or react.
Tapa, handball by Amrab Kiyov. So it will be an India free kick. Stimac just on the edge of his technical area. He added Trevor Sinclair to his coaching staff as assistant coach and set piece coach. Just a couple of weeks before this tournament, they were former teammates at West Ham. They played there for a couple of years at the end of the 90s and the early 2000s. India haven't had a set piece yet, so we haven't had a chance to see what kind of work Trevor Sinclair's been doing with them, but plenty of time to go. Mahesh brought down to win a free kick, so right on cue. This is India's chance to maybe get Sandesh Jingan and Ralbeke forward.
Well, this is the kind of thing that will just annoy Srećko Katanić slightly, putting themselves under pressure from the set piece situation. Burunov, should attack on the jersey of Naurem. We need good quality from the deliveries.
Sunil Chetri is taking responsibility, a man who's scored a lot of headed goals in his time, but who's not the tallest player in the world. But he rises exceptionally well, but he is the man over the ball.
It's the timing, isn't it? It's just the timing of Elim. Are you able to read the flight of the ball?
Well, they tried that short free kick into Apoya. It was obviously something that they've practiced because Apoya's movement away from his man, but the referee hadn't blown the whistle, so I might have just telegraphed things a little for Uzbekistan here at the second chance. This time it's Anirudh Thapa making a run across the one-man wall. Chetri moves away again. No, he doesn't. He comes back and Anirudh Thapa comes back again. It is Chetri this time. Into Akash Mishra. But he got ahead to it, but couldn't get enough direction on the ball to hit the target.
Well, you had to see them try something a little bit different from the set-piece situations because they do lack that height in the area. They tried to change it up with the first one. They got a second go at it. This time around, just looking to play it into the box. As that Uzbekistan back line dropped off, that created a little bit of space for the header from Mishra.
Uzbekistan have never qualified for a FIFA World Cup finals, which probably the squad they have at the moment and their early two results in the qualifying, this could be their best chance with the extended version, of course, coming up in 2026. There is Trevor Sinclair, great servant, played 12 times for England, played at the 2002 World Cup when he was a late replacement for Danny Murphy. Uzbekistan did win the Asian Games gold medal in Japan in 1994. Quarter-finalists in 2015 in Australia. They had a wonderful tournament. Beat Saudi Arabia and DPR Korea. Went out in the quarter-finals to the Korean Republic after extra time. But they're a nation you feel that's on the cusp of really bursting onto international football. And this is a big stage for them here to emphasise that and put the rubber stamp on that, really.
We just saw that moment from India, Sunil Chetri. Just looking to try and close down, but he was going on his own. And as he looked behind for the support in the press to arrive, it just wasn't quite there. They have to really time their pressing here and make sure they're pressing together as a unit. There's no point going out on your own when there's no follow-through from behind. It'll just leave gaps in your shape. Jari, lean on Masharipov.
Yeah, clever movement again by Masharipov, who just worked the ball quickly and really drew the foul off Nikhil Pujari. Nazruliev trying to press it back, almost got a foot on the ball. It was just laid in field to Shukra. Should be comfortable for Gurpreet. Still India's number one. Goalkeeper Gurpreet Singh Sandhu making his 70th international appearance. Amrinder Singh and Vishal Keith are the two goalkeepers on the bench, equally competent. Amrinder Singh was given the nod in that friendly World Cup qualifier against Qatar a few weeks ago. And the reason for that was just because Igor Stimac wanted to put him into a pressure match situation because he's an unknown quantity with Gurpreet occupying that jersey. Fortunately, India were outclassed on the night by 3-0, and having seen Qatar play twice here, it's not surprising. Good ball down the line for Naren Mahesh. Safiyev, but to Husanov rather with a challenge, another throw given by the Chinese referee.
And it's twice now, Husanov has gone charging into an Indian player down that side of the pitch, really looking to use his physicality.
Anirudh Thapa going over. Sharapov again, teasing Nikhil Pujari. Nice in reverse ball for Zuliev. Trying to pull it back, but Apoya was back on defensive duty to stab that behind for the corner. But the man coming into the side, in fact, the two men coming into the side are causing all the problems for Zuliev and Sigayev. Both have got a goal to their name, but for Zuliev's looking very lively.
He is, and that link-up with Masharapov has been very good. Sergeyev as well having a good game. There's a lot of talk about Shomurodov and his absence, and yes, of course, they'll miss a playoff. His quality, he's absolutely brilliant, but at some point you've got to stop talking about him and start focusing on the players who are here. And it's good to see he's gone with Sergeyev this evening. Of a natural centre-forward option, kind of playing with Urunov up front in the last game. Great dividends so far.
Towards that near post area, headed away again by Sunil Chetri. Held back in by Fazuliev, who's quickly back on defensive duty to cover for players that are a little bit slower than him. 20 years of age, he's got a lot more in the legs. One more game to come today, don't forget, a little bit later on, it's 8:30 local time, Palestine against the UAE. Then tomorrow, three big matches, Iraq against Japan, Vietnam against Indonesia, and Hong Kong, China against Iran. It's hard to believe that we've already completed one round of matches, and by tomorrow we'll be well into the second round of matches here in Qatar, a week since the tournament got underway. Over the top, just enough for Zuliev, straight at Gerbry, and then shepherded back by Ralbeke. But once again, clever play by Uzbekistan creating the opening. Gerbry is a big, big target to get past them.
Great acceleration there from Fazuliev. Nice bit of movement as well off the ball. But the pass that was just played into him, right above the head of Sandeshjingen. Brilliant weight on that pass. Spread himself, stood up as long as he possibly could there. Gurbri managed to deny Fazuliev.
India yet to test Yusupov in the Uzbekistan goal. Poya bends that one into the path of Anirudh Thapa. Pujari urging him to come forward, helps it on. Thapa though was a little bit behind the players. He tried to go down the outside of Nazruliev. India throw. 10 minutes to go to half time. Can India get something from this game before half time? It would give them a bit of a spring in their step going into the break, but this defence has held firm so far from Uzbekistan. Given away clumsily by Pujari. Good challenge by Suresh Wangja. Ralbeke. Suresh. Poya. To go back to basics and start to build from inside their own half. Ralbeke. Naran Mahesh coming short all the way back to Gerbry. That'll give Uzbekistan the license to press almost up to the halfway line.
That was good defending from Safiev, just tracking the run of Naran, not allowing him to receive and turn and face forward. Uzbekistan quite happy in these moments now, just to sit off India a little bit. They'll allow them to have the ball as long as it's not in dangerous areas off the pitch. Pick the moments to apply that pressure. Sergeyev looking to try and lead the way. As long as it goes backwards and sideways, they'll be very happy, Uzbekistan.
Great atmosphere in the stadium again. All the games have been so well supported here. Everywhere you go in Qatar, there's branding for this competition. Right opposite our hotel, there's floor to ceiling on the skyscrapers of the five mascots that are here. Here's Nikhil Pujari, Sunil Chetri, good movement away from his man. Thapa, Apuya, Pujari, can he get a good cross in here? Trying to just feed that one in rather than hit it with pace. And eventually it's turned back towards his own Garbar Shmudarov, and the corner prevented by Yusupov, who has to save from his own defender.
Well, here's another look at that pass from Masharipov, a replay of that chance earlier. Fazuliev couldn't put away. Beautiful weight on that pass. Just chips it over into the penalty area.
Good play by Akash Mishra to win the ball back. Uzbekistan giving it away in their final third once again. Curled in, pushed away. Yusupov almost seemed too low to punch that one. He was almost on the ground when he punched that ball away, but it's had the desired effect. But it was well read by Akash Mishra, and that'll be a drop ball. It's the back of Fu Ming, the referee, who says, well, I couldn't get out of the way.
had his back to the play as well. Just turned around, is expecting that pass from Sandesh Jingan to go forward. So a bit of a controversy involving the referee in a different position yesterday between Qatar and Tajikistan. This time around actually hits the referee.
It's given away again to Sergeyev, but he spotted Gurpreet off his line, but hit the ball well wide of the target. He is the most appearances and most goals for Uzbekistan. Just when we saw Igor Stimats a moment or so ago, a man who had such a great career as a player, of course, he was in the Croatia squad that finished third at the 1998 World Cup in France. Of course, it was Stephen Constantine, the man that was in charge in the UAE 5 years ago. He departed at the end of the tournament and Igor Stimats came in. Some stability, and that new contract means that he will extend his stay, which is into its fifth year already.
Done a good job of it, Igor Stimac. You can see that development in the game for India. You can see how they've grown as well over the years. But still, of course, as always, you're always looking for that improvement. Like you'll always say there's still some ways to go till they're really challenging. But there's one thing you cannot doubt about this Indian national side is the players will give absolutely everything. Nothing wrong with the effort that they put in. They'll work hard, they'll graft, they will fight for their flag, but they just need a little bit of guile, they need a little bit of creativity.
Suresh getting forced to go backwards. Nikhil Pujari, short pass once again, and just one or two little individual errors are creeping into India's play. Just a little bit too keen, I think, to try and get the ball forward. Misharipov. Sergeyev. Good ball across. Good defending that time from Akash Mishra. Offside flag has gone up, though, so it wouldn't have counted. But once again, Uzbekistan looking to get in behind that Indian defence and cause plenty of problems.
Well, it's that breakdown of play. It's a transition again. Just doesn't quite bend his run enough yet. Sergeyev just leaning offside. Raul Beke doing well to hold his line. But you can see when it breaks down and when Uzbekistan are able to get it forward quickly, Masharipov is in an acres of space. I think on a player of that quality, you allow him that time and space on the ball. Allow him that time to get his head up. He's got the quality to pick out those passes forward.
Way by Gurpreet. Too high though for Nikhil Pujari. So possession handed back, 18th edition of the AFC Asian Cup. Five cities hosting 51 matches, some wonderful stadiums as well. We were up at Al Bayt yesterday, wonderful stadium there up in Al Khor. A good game last night as Qatar booked their place, the first team to book their place in the knockout stage. The holders, of course, looking to become a rare animal in winning the trophy on home soil. Only five teams have managed that in the past. Australia were the most recent, back in 2015. They too have won earlier to book their place in the round of 16. Of course, this extended version of the tournament now since UAE, where 24 teams start. It's a foul on Raul Beke. It's the free kick inside his own area from Urinov.
It's good, strong defending from Raul Beke. Got in. Goal side as well, close to the ball. You can see that tug on the jersey from Urunov. Much better defending this time around, having to cover large spaces here. The two central defenders of India, Sandesh Jingan and Raul Beke.
We talk about Sunil Chhetri being such a great member of the Indian side. Uzbekistan had Ignatiev Nesterov, who played five tournaments between 2004 and 2019, an incredible achievement to play in five tournaments that are only every 4 years.
The longevity of these players. But you mentioned him being a goalkeeper, and the intensity Not very high. Goalkeepers. More impressive with Çetri. Playing up front, expected to close down as well. And I mean, there were question marks about whether he would be starting matches in this competition. I think he's still there, still delivering for his country. What he can do on the pitch and off the pitch as well.
Suresh. It's a corner, flag stayed down. It was at a tight decision, or a tight one over on that far side, but corner given away by Husinov. So India was in fact a throw-in right in the corner, in fact. It might have gone for a corner. India supporters trying to get behind their team. Uzbekistan fans behind Yusupov's goal. Naran Mahesh trying to weave his way into the area, couldn't stay on his feet. Akuya. Beke. We're trying to push that one through to Manvir, well read by Amrabikov. It's a Poyer. Poor. Clumsy challenge that from Fazulayev. Say that the opening goal in this game could be vitally important, and Uzbekistan, who scored it earlier on, sure the last thing Igor Stimac wanted in his team talk was to concede so early and then to concede another one not too long after it. And these players have got to rally themselves now for the second half. We're into the final minute of the first 45 here at the Ahmed Bin Ali Stadium in Al Rayyan. Better looking delivery, still too close to the keeper, went for the punch once again though. It's Naran Mahesh! Good save, Yusupov! Caught it brilliantly, Naran Mahesh, who scored his first international goal last year.
Good effort from Naran. Just trying to catch out Uzbekistan's goalkeeper. The noise is incredible here. They sense something, the Indian fans. Turning on the pressure. And they make use of this corner here, India.
Tapper to swing this one over. Three header. Sunil Çetri once again, who, well, there's so much rides on his shoulders. Missed that diving header against Australia. That was a slightly more awkward one, but couldn't keep the header down.
Yeah, just couldn't quite get the contact right. You can see it struck the top of his head. Just on the way down, rather than up and above the ball. But they've given the fans something to shout about, something to get excited about. And they're doing much better in attack in this game. A couple of decent chances. Good shot earlier that from Naurem. In the corner for his side.
Yeah, Igor Stimac, who's won 19 of his 47 games in charge of India prior to this. There's Apoya. Away by Gurpreet. Looking for Pujari again, just a little bit too high for Nikhil Pujari. Will be a free kick to India. Into 5 minutes added time at the end of the first half. I'm not too sure where 5 minutes has come from, but possibly the goal celebrations, which were a little bit long. But India just showing at the end of this first half that they're not prepared to be out of this. 2-0 is always a fragile lead. If India get the next goal, it drags them right back into it. If Uzbekistan gets the next goal, then you feel that the game is over. But India won't give this one up, you can be sure of that.
There's Igor Stimac there. Didn't want to give the ball to Masharipov, having a few words, the two of them. Just hanging on to it, the coach, and he's gonna he's having a bit of advice from the fourth official, telling not to get involved with the ball. And he just wanted to allow his team to get themselves back settled.
Well, Naran Mahesh. Suresh and Akash Mishra started to combine well down that left-hand side. That's why they were brought into the side today. Both exciting players. Mishra, who plays for Mumbai City, the current Indian Super League Shield winners. Naren Mahesh, who plays for East Bengal. Led away by Raul Beke. There's Urunov. Overlap coming here from Sufiev. Good-looking ball as well, just too high for Zoyev off the post! And the rebound falls kindly to him. And Nazruliyev, who came forward, gets the final touch. Well, India switched off once again. It's the fullback in a forward position. Nazruliyev, his initial shot came back off the post. And a simple side foot into the empty net. And that third goal has come Uzbekistan's way in first half stoppage time.
And he gets fortunate with that rebound falling straight back into him. But credit to Uzbekistan. They've done very well. They've made the most of these opportunities. They've been very efficient, very effective in attack. Again, India is going to sleep. Manveer there. His body shape is all wrong. Needs to open up. I'll have a look over his shoulder at that run from Nazruliyev. Again, sneaking in on the blind side. Getting the numbers into the box. And it's just a little bit too naive from India. Lack of awareness defensively. What did I say earlier? The quality that you're coming up against. You make mistakes like that, they tend to be punished. I sense the frustration from Igor Stimac.
Yeah, Nazruliyev was the third player coming into the starting lineup. It's his first international goal and his 16th appearance.
Three changes while getting on the score sheet for Uzbekistan.
Inspired, I'm sure. We'll hear from the coach afterwards, Srechko Katanets. But he wanted a response from his team after that disappointing 0-0 against Syria, and he's certainly got that here in the first half.
Yeah, he mentioned he wasn't happy at all with the performance. He wanted a lot more from his side in attack. He made those changes, changed the tactical shape as well. He's having a chat this morning. Had a breakfast with one of the other members of our commentary team, suggesting that Uzbekistan would perhaps look to go with four in this game. Being the better side, having the better quality, being able to push players into more advanced areas. Let's bring in Faizuliyev in, who's looked so lively. There he is again, looking to make that run.
India goal kick. In fact, the referee decides there's no time for the goal kick. There goes the half-time whistle. Well, both these sides knew that they had to win if they wanted to give themselves a really good chance of going through to the next stage. And Uzbekistan have come out firing. Three early goals for Zuliyev, Sergeyev and Nazruliyev in first half stoppage time. And you really fear for India in this second half. If they can get a goal back, it might steady the ship and give them a little bit of confidence. But their heads are down a little at the moment as they troop in for half time.
Yeah, so important. Second 45 coming up for India. Uzbekistan are cruising along here. And for them, it's an opportunity to actually get more goals added to their tally. But headed towards all 3 points for India, there's a real danger that this could become a very ugly scoreline.
Well, it is Uzbekistan who lead the way here. Half-time at the Ahmed Bin Ali. It's India 0, Uzbekistan 3.
继续拼尽全力，沿着这条印记出发吧，少年们，让你的对手和队友都能记住你的名字，在未来的足球世界。
magnitude of these stadiums here in Qatar. Fu Ming from China is our referee, was a referee in 2019, refereed two games back in the UAE against Yemen, against Iraq, and UAE against Kurd Republic. And he gets us underway for the second half. Real uphill battle here for India. And the last thing they would have wanted, they conceded a goal very early on. They conceded a third goal very late on in that half.
Yeah, it could get really painful for India. If they're not careful in this second half, Uzbekistan really just enjoying themselves, especially on this left-hand side. The relationship between Masharipov and Fazuliev has been so much fun to watch. Getting the goals, and they headed towards the 3 points, and it could add a few more as well.
Well, they're on the attack straight away at the start of the second half. That's flicked away by Naren Mahesh. Of course, if India do manage to get a result against Syria and go into the third place sort of mini league table, if you like, goal difference could play a part. So they won't want to try and leak too many tonight. They certainly won't be going all out attack to try and overturn this deficit, but they'll try and take what they can get. Abdi Rakhatov, who's been at FC Nassaf in Uzbekistan all his career, it's only his second international appearance. Made his debut at the tail end of 2023, so a big moment for him playing in an AFC Asian Cup. Fazuliev just ran away from him slightly. Sandesh Jingan played it away to Suresh Wangchan, who's under pressure. Nikhil Pujari, Suresh was just caught. Igor Stimats is missing a couple of key players on the bench today, we mentioned earlier on. Look at that shot again, though, with this brilliant stadium.
Yeah, it is beautiful, isn't it? We've experienced some great venues, outstanding stadiums here in Qatar. Fazuliev steps on the foot of Suresh.
They hosted seven matches in the FIFA World Cup here, including Argentina, Australia, which drew the biggest crowd. Kurds Republic against Saudi Arabia will play here in 3 days' time. There'll be a big crowd for that one as well. The Saudi Arabians superbly supported at the Khalifa Stadium the other night. But as we were saying, Lister Colasso and Vikram, who is a lively character, both picked up knocks in that first game, so unavailable tonight, along with Sahal Abu Sa'ad, who's still carrying a knock from the Indian Super League season.
You'd imagine they would have benefited greatly as well from Anwar Ali being made available, but I spoke earlier about Shomurodov not being available for Uzbekistan, and probably should just talk about the players who are here with this squad. India, when you look at their side, when you look at the profiles of players that they have, Mishra just going into the back of Apuya. Knee into the spine, painful one for Apuya, but he's back up on his feet, good to see. There are some players here who've got the capacity to play a possession-based game, but it's just not quite enough, and that's something they need to look at in terms of their development overall moving forward, in terms of the kinds of players that they bring through. More technical quality required at this level. We spoke about the heart, the determination, the fight. That's all there, no doubt about it.
Just kept in play by Nikhil Pujari.
Uzbekistan being afforded a lot of space in this match. They were frustrated against Syria. Very compact, very organized. Carrying a bit of a threat going forward as well.
India did make a change at half-time as well, by the way, which just passed us by a little. Raul KP has come on for Manvia. That's flipped away by the goalkeeper. Hits the post. What a glorious opportunity for Raul KP, who's only just come on. Chetri can't get a touch. Gets another one away for the corner. Well, India inches away from getting back into this game. Lovely ball in from Mishra.
There's a flap by the goalkeeper, Yusupov. They're so unlucky here, India. Sunil Chetri perhaps should be doing a lot better with that. It's just in behind him. I don't think there's any pace in the ball as it comes into him. So perhaps in that situation, all he can really do is just try and direct it towards goal. They're so unfortunate with it. Coming off the frame, off the goal. But once more, these Indian fans have just been brilliant.
Incredible atmosphere overcomes the corner into Chetri, who went with a flick, but over the top. So Raul KP coming on at half-time. Here's another look at it again. Yusupov didn't deal with it. And Raul KP with his first touch, almost becoming a bit of a hero.
That's right, Yusupov, I think, is just getting caught out of position. There might have been a bit of a deflection on that cross, you know, which is why Yusupov just got caught out a little bit. Just looking on, see it come off the post there. And it's been a big difference between Uzbekistan and India. We spoke of Uzbekistan's effectiveness, how efficient they were in attack with the chances that they had. Even when it came off the frame of the goal, it would fall to an Uzbekistan player to apply the finish. India just not quite getting the rub of the green.
Yeah, put yourself in the sort of mindset of Igor Stimac, you know, going in 3-0 down. He was preparing a team talk for 2-0 down, and then, of course, in Uzbekistan scored that very late goal. What could he have said to his team that will just give them that little bit of a boost in the second half to just keep going?
It's almost a case of saying to them, look, try and forget about that first half and then try and win this second half now. That's gone, first 45, didn't go to plan at all. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to bring Raul KP on, a little bit of a different sort of player than Manvir Singh. We'll try and see if we can get him a little bit more involved in the attack and focus on tightening up at the back here. So forget about the first 45. Let's look at what we can do in this second half. Maybe if we get a goal, might be a few nerves perhaps. But I think they'll want to be focused as well on making sure they're a lot more compact, because Uzbekistan were given so much time and space in the first half.
There's the man who scored the first goal, the youngster Fazulayev. He's 20 years of age, his third international goal, putting them Uzbekistan into an early lead here. That's given away to Sergeyev. It's not a good ball there. We'll go out and play for goal kick. Sharapov was the player trying to get on the end of it. Well, that wasn't inside the six-yard box, so Gerbrit will have to take goal kick again. Well, the Uzbekistan fans have made plenty of noise right through, and rightly so. They're in a block of fans. We just see them there at the top of the screen behind Gerbrit's goal. But that drum has... I don't think that drum's stopped for the whole 50 minutes so far.
Well, you've got two sets of drums. You've got the Uzbekistan fans there in that small pocket, and then above them you've got the blue pilgrims also on their drums for India.
Yeah, very colourful scene here. Lots of fans dressing up with the face paint and wearing their team's colours. It has been a wonderfully vivid event to watch so far over the last week or so. It's very much in evidence as well. The fan parks have been full. There are lots of places you can go and watch the matches around Doha and the surrounding areas. And say attendances have been magnificent so far as well. As a foul on Naren Mahesh, which will give India a free kick. Not too much doubt about that one, just a clumsy challenge. This is Suresh. Started this second half a lot deeper. Apoya just sitting almost between his two central defenders at the moment. Here come Uzbekistan with Misharapov. It's played into the gap once again, but another poor pass, giving Misharapov no chance of getting onto that one from Fazulayev. Uzbekistan have one game to go, of course, against Australia. That will determine who finishes top of the group if it stays this way. Australians, of course, the 2015 winners. Kuzunov going back towards his own goal. Yusupov with a clearance away. Raul Beke's header, real tussle with Sergeyev. Fazulayev. Here's the bit of space here for Sifiev, who's swapped to left back in the second half after that substitution of Nazruliev. Rakitov has come on to the right back position. Here he is. Just got there to win that ball back for Uzbekistan. Durinov went on ahead of him, back to Shukrov. Rakitov. Spotted Eshmuradov in some space. Sifiev. Nice play. Uzbekistan, Suresh trying to get across. It does well. Good covering job there from Suresh Wangchamp. Sandesh Jingat needs to be quicker, get this one away because he's under pressure. Fortunately, he's won a foul. He's a little bit lucky there, Sandesh Jingat, trying to dribble out of his own penalty area, but was caught with three Uzbekistan players around him.
Sandesh Jingat eventually getting a way out, being given a free kick. Was almost caught in possession there. Sergeyev having a look, wondering what he actually did wrong. That was a bit of a clip.
Supporters hoping that they can play a part in helping their side get back into this one. So they only managed that one shot on target against Australia in their opening match. That effort that hit the post from Raul Kepik doesn't go down as an effort on target, of course. But it is the closest India have come to scoring in this game. Suresh. Pressure there from Amrekiov. It's poor play from Nikol Pajari on that far side to hand the ball back to Uzbekistan. India had its real golden era back in the 1950s and 60s. And Syed Abdul Rahim won two Asian Games gold medals in the 50s, in the 50s and 60s. Your Indian football, they can list one of the greats, PK Banerjee, who won 31 trophies with East Bengal as one of their former coaches. Stephen Constantine, of course, the man that guided them 2019, and Wim Kuvermans, the Dutchman who was in charge for a spell of the Indian national team as well. Good ball across. Better defending though from Raul Beke. Knew he had to get a foot on that with Sugiyev just in front of him. Cut out by Abdurakhimov because Akash Mishra was right behind him looking to utilise some clear space that would have opened up in front of him. Chukrov. Uzbekistan just able to control the pace of the game at the moment,
yeah.
Leading 3-0.
Just so comfortable with that advantage, the three goals that they've scored, and the fact that India now as well are just, I think, a bit wary, a bit cautious of opening up too much, trying to stay more compact.
Raul Kepik is one of the fastest players in the Indian Super League. If India can get the ball to him, maybe his pace can cause a few problems, but there's a challenge on Urunov. Two defenders coming across and just sandwiching him out. I don't think there was anything untoward in that. But better defending from India, Sandesh Jingan and Raul Beke.
Strong challenge from Sandesh.
I think India were thinking about putting the ball out of play there, but Urunov is back on his feet now, so they will continue.
I always think players have got absolutely the right to carry on and play the ball. You play to the whistle. If the referee thinks it's serious enough, he should stop the match.
The signs of how Uzbekistan have improved over the last 20 years or so. They went out in the first two editions that they took part in this competition in the group stages, but finished bottom of the group in 96 and 2000. But from 2004, they reached the quarterfinals two successive years, fourth place in 2011. And 2019 is the first time they failed to make it beyond the round of six, or be into the quarterfinals rather, since 2004. A nation that is growing in stature in footballing terms.
They've got a good group, really solid group of young players coming through as well, making waves at youth level on the international stage. Uzbekistan and those players coming through into the senior international side, making a big impact as well. Fazulev, one of those, and of course, you've got Kusanov in central defence, who looks incredible. A man mountain in that back line, so strong. There's another look at. And this challenge from Sandesh. Sandesh Jingan didn't get too much contact on the ball. He does collide with his own teammate.
And let's not forget, Uzbekistan did win the AFC Under-23 Asian Cup back in 2018. Another solid challenge from Huzanov at the back. Those two central defenders are real no-nonsense, Ishmudarov and Huzanov. Don't take any prisoners in that final third. Akash Mishra with the India throw. Apuya trying to spin away from his man and find some space. Naren Mahesh, India working the ball along the line. Sandesh Jingan. Not a good ball from Jingan at all. You could see he was just trying to get in to play Raul KP in, but didn't execute it very well.
I think he wanted to just try and throw the pass through, didn't make it a true pass when the better option would have been just a simple pass out wide. Trying to get around the Uzbekistan back line.
Sandesh Jingan actually scored his first Indian Super League goal this season after making over 100 appearances without scoring a goal. He's flicked on by Sunil Chetri. Sifiev. Easily done. Ashmudarov. Sifiev. Confident about the way Uzbekistan just stroked the ball around under no great pressure and perfectly relaxed even when they're playing out in an almost pressure situation. Given away by Nikhil Pajari, who's out of position now. Fazuliev bursting into the box. Too much on the ball in for Sergeyev. He may have got himself, but the angle just narrowed for him, so he tried to play on his teammate, but well, he got too much on it, and Uranov was chasing shadows. Chetri. Lucky bounce, two defenders getting in each other's way. Here's Anirudh Thapa. Now Raul KP is in space. Sifiev goes across to try and close him down. Naram's just inside him. Got the ball caught under his feet there, Raul KP. And, well, he was almost in two minds as to whether to try and shoot or cross it. And in the end, the ball just bobbles harmlessly through to Yusupov.
Encouraging there, that move forward from India. But the moment it went out to Raul KP, just couldn't quite sort his feet out or decide what he wanted to do in that moment. Eventually getting crowded out and turning it over. Attack coming to nothing for India.
He's on his feet again, the Uzbekistan coach. Srećko Katanets, the 60-year-old Slovenian. Joined Uzbekistan after coaching Iraq for 3 years. He's been in charge a couple of years now. Fazuliev just drags the shot wide on that occasion. India would have hoped to try and get themselves something from their first two games, but when you consider the difference in the quality and the rankings, particularly Australia, we know have just gone up another couple of places to 25 in the FIFA rankings, where Uzbekistan at 69, they did drop a place in Monday's new rankings. Syria are the other team in the group, of course, and India know that they will have to beat Syria in that final game if they want to stand any chance of going through as a best third place team. Still Uzbekistan full of running. Sharapov just managed to dig the cross out. No real call from Gurpri. Given away by Sandesh Jingan again. But he got away with that one. But just confusion at the back there from India. Gurpri didn't command the situation. And they almost got themselves into trouble.
Yeah, some of it has been very clumsy, very rushed from India. And defence especially. We saw those mistakes, individual mistakes. Almost another one from Sandesh Jingan. It's just looking at India in possession as well. You see the difference in these little details, and it all adding up. Passes going astray, not being able to find the runner in front of you.
I've got a few striking options, or more positive options, on the bench for Igor Stimac, Ishan Pandita, who is still trying to live up to his expectations. Lali Zwalichangte, who played the first game. Brandon Fernandez, we haven't seen as yet. Nora Danta, who again is another player with a little bit of pace on the bench. But no out-and-out goal scorer for India. If you take Sunil Chhetri out of the equation, I mean, when you look at Sunil Chhetri's record, 146 internationals, 93 goals. It's aimed in towards Sunil Chhetri.
Well, he's thinking about those changes, Igor Stimac. Just seeing some of those names you've mentioned, Ishan Pandita out there warming up. Changte as well is there.
Gujari tried to get that one across first time, and again, just lacking the quality. Just sails harmlessly behind, and the Uzbekistan central defenders have barely been tested in those central areas tonight. Pajari, who makes his 23rd appearance tonight for India. Well, they came here full of expectation, those Indian supporters. They came through with expectation that they could get through to the round of 16. When you look at India's ranking back in 2014, before the Indian Super League, or when the Indian Super League started, India were down in the 170s in the rankings. Now they're just outside the top 100. They did briefly go inside the top 100 last year. But it just goes to show that there is progression, there is positive movement in the right direction for Indian football. But they are coming up against opposition that are bigger, better and stronger than them at the moment.
Yeah, you know, it's always going to take time. It's a long process, isn't it? You've got to try and wait for that sort of next group of players to come along, and you're hoping that they're coached well, they're coached in the right way, and they develop in the right way. When you think about development, it's almost always in these sort of 10-year cycles, in a sense.
Fazulayev just helped that onto Sifiev, all the way across the way by Akash Mishra. Fazulayev. Flowing move from Uzbekistan down that far side. Hamrabikov. Abdurakhatov. Shukrov. Nice ball down the line again for the runner, Vurunov. Have found those little pockets in the corners well tonight, Uzbekistan.
Well, again, it's a lovely flowing move down the left. All of their good work has essentially come down that left-hand side. They're able to just overload India down that side of the pitch. Quality of their play, excellent relationships out on the pitch there. Masharipov as well, just really enjoying himself, being able to drift across. This time around, coming across to the right, back into the centre.
Difficult to dispossess Uzbekistan. Kuzunov, Eshmudarov. To the final quarter of the game. Lovely ball with the outside of the foot to find Urunov, if he can keep it in play, which he does just. Abdurakhatov, too much on that, trying to feed that round the defender to Shukrov. Raul KP has got away from his man. Now can he get down the line? No, he can't, because it's a good challenge from Sifiev, who managed to get back into position. We'll see Brandon Fernandez coming in a moment. He was just getting some instructions from Igor Stimac down on the sidelines, and he is just taking his pink bib off down in front of us. So we will be seeing the FC Goa captain coming on in just a moment. Abdurakhatov. Sharapov. Running again down that far side from Sifiev. He's been lively in the second half, having swapped sides. Fazulayev. Sifiev's gone for the return. Took a couple of touches off Indian defenders in the middle. The first one off Anuruddhappa, which could have gone anywhere. Fortunately, he went away from goal. Abdurakhatov. Uzbekistan going in search of a fourth goal. No addition to that half-time score as yet here at the Ahmed Bin Hali Stadium in Al Rayyan. Paul Ball gathered by Gurpreet.
Again, it's coming down this left-hand side. Sefiev showing his versatility. Playing right back in the first half, moving across to the left in this second. Again, it's a quick one-touch combination play. A give and go, so difficult to defend. We spoke about that in the first half. Just moves too quickly for you. The moment you get to the player, not close enough, the ball's gone. You try and follow the runner, but always difficult in those situations, really, to keep up with the pace.
Well, Beke's header. It's well played by Suresh, just nodding that one back to Gerbry. Well, Beke's header didn't really have too much direction on it, almost caused his defence a few more problems. It was again Raul KP the target. Suresh wins the loose ball back. Well, to stay on his feet there, Suresh. Raul Beke. Apuya. Uzbekistan's shape means it's difficult for India just to try and work any openings or work any gaps. Now here's Raul KP spinning away from Ishmudarov, who recovered well to stab the ball behind. It will be a corner, but that's good defending against the pace of Raul KP.
He had to really time his challenge very well. Was caught out by the acceleration of Raul KP. Got his head up, was looking for the cutback. That's a good challenge from Ishmudarov.
Brandon Fernandes is coming on, as is Ishan Pandita. Sunil Chetri making way, and Anirudh Thapa is the other player to go off as well. Ishan Pandita, just one international goal so far, came back in qualifying for this tournament in 2021 against Hong Kong. What he wouldn't give for another goal now. A man who has been used mainly as a substitute over his career so far. But a man who played in Spain and was coached by the great Walter Pandiani, the Uruguayan striker who used to stay behind after training with the goalkeeper and practice his shooting. Something he learned a lot from back in those days in his younger career. Raul Beke's header, Yusupov tips it over the top. And India close once again, but still they can't find a way through.
Good delivery, well-timed lead from Raul Beke, straight down the middle, unfortunately for him. Just redirecting that, using the pace on the corner. To ideally go either side of the goalkeeper.
Brandon Fernandes with the corner in towards that near post area. Sandesh Jingan got a touch, but Yusupov again gathers the ball in cleanly. But India have had chances in this game.
Another look at that save, just palmed over by the goalkeeper Yusupov. You'd expect keepers to make those sorts of saves.
Uzbekistan edging up to second place in the group. India and Syria. Well, Syria would have a point, of course. India would be bottom of the group. Syria got that 0-0 draw against Uzbekistan in their first game. Double change coming up here for Uzbekistan. Sharapov is going off. And Urinov also making way. There's a chance for Turgenboyev to come on, and Birkinov also coming into the action. Turgenboyev, the number 19 on the left there, did play at the Asian Cup in the UAE, played against Japan and Australia, but only managed a total of 38 minutes. Comes on here for potentially 16 minutes plus stoppage time in this one.
An opportunity for Srećko Katanić to make those changes, try and manage the fitness of his players as well. Important players in Masharipov and Urunov coming off and being given a bit of a break, with the game pretty much won here.
Birkinov, who's on loan at Paktikor from Torpedo Moscow at the moment. Raul KP. Play that one inside to Brandon Fernandes. Zuliev. Sergeyev. Both these teams will have a change of venue for their final games. India go to Al Bayt in Alcor, where we were last night for the Qatar game, and Uzbekistan Australia will be at Al Janoub in Al Wakra, which is another stadium that all the stadiums fairly close together. I think we passed two of the stadiums on the way here, didn't we? Education City being one of them. Still bursting forward here, Uzbekistan. That was Erkinov, the substitute. Sifiev, Hamrabikov. 38,491 other excellent attendance here at this AFC Asian Cup in Qatar 2023. So well over 1 million advance tickets have been sold for this event. But there's still, I would imagine, tickets for the casual supporters to come and support either A team or just come as a neutral and enjoy some good football and enjoy the atmosphere and everything that goes around it. We came out of the stadium last night, didn't we? And the Qatari fans were dancing on a stage and playing music and drums. It was just a really incredible atmosphere.
You know, real fun atmosphere all around the matches here as well. You mentioned the fan zones, the viewing zones where you can go and watch matches as well here in Qatar. And just all around, I mean, you really get a feel for the excitement going into these grounds. Good support, good atmosphere that we've had in all the games that we've covered, I think.
I actually look forward to a day off when I can actually go and watch a game as a fan.
Yeah. And you went to go and watch the Saudi Arabia-Oman game as an observer, yeah.
Fantastic the other night in the Khalifa Stadium. A brilliant occasion. And a reminder, there is another game to come tonight as well. Palestine against the UAE, 20:30 local time. And then tomorrow, Iraq against Japan, Vietnam against Indonesia, and Hong Kong against Iran. We'll be at the Khalifa Stadium for that one tomorrow.
Oh, looking forward to that Iraq-Japan game. That's a big one.
Here, Uzbekistan are in control, as they have been since the early stages of the game when Fazuliyev put them into an early 1-0 lead. Sergeyev adding to that. And Nazruliyev chipping in with his first international goal as well. Here comes Turgunboyev. Shukrov. Fazuliyev from a long way out took a deflection, which wasn't much pace in the shot anyway, but it meant it was fairly comfortable for Gurpreet Singh Sandhi.
Yeah, needed another pass, an additional pass out to the left-hand side. He had Erkinov there in support. Could have just gone out to him. Hungry for more goals. Fazuliyev.
Dieter just tried to go shoulder to shoulder with Huzanov, but he just had enough to get there in front of him. Pandita will chase all night, though. He's one of those honest, hard-working players, Ishan Pandita, trying to close down goalkeepers. But he's offside, so he won't be able to challenge for that ball.
Well, that's another thing we were talking about earlier. Again, there's no doubt about the work rate. You mentioned honest and hard-working. That's what we can expect from this Indian side. But really, there's a massive gulf in the class and the quality, the technical ability at this level, and the pace of play when the pressure is really on. And Uzbekistan have that ability, something that perhaps India and sides like that don't really have in this competition. I'll come back to it after this.
Mistake by Pajari, who just committed himself too early. Good save by Gurpreet, and a good block to deny Turgunboyev. Uzbekistan just turning that pressure tap just a little at the end of the game here. That's another good-looking ball in aim towards Erkinov. This time, Pajari did manage to get ahead on it.
And again, it's happened on the left-hand side. How often have I said that during this match? The fresh legs of Erkinov. Right idea with the cutback. Sefias just couldn't find the finish. Well, just going back to the point I was trying to make earlier, is that the sides like India, you get the sense that they're playing at their maximum level, at their maximum intensity, whereas when you look at some of the bigger teams here, the likes of Uzbekistan, for example, they've got gears they can go through.
Well, here's Pandita on the chase, but once again, he's caught out for pace. It was played through to him by Naramahesh. It was a mistake in midfield by Uzbekistan. But a Shapandita didn't quite have the legs to get to that loose ball. That last shot, by the way, was by Asifiev, who's dropped in at left back. Weird would it have been if two left backs would have scored for Uzbekistan tonight. That's just out of the reach of Erkinov and will be gathered by Gerbry.
Good play from Sergeyev. Really the right idea as well, just trying to play in behind for Erkinov. A bit too much pace on the pass.
Back with Raubeke. India will go away, they will regroup, they will try to come up with a plan to beat Syria. They were really dealt that hammer blow by those two early goals in the first half, and then that late goal in stoppage time from Nazruliev, and there really was no way back. But at the moment, we talk about coaches taking positives. They haven't conceded in the second half, so can it stay that way? Raubeke, Akash Mishra. Sandis Jingin. Well, KP up ahead of him. Nice flick off to Brandon. Pujari. Well, the referee has given the foul. The assistant gave the throw in the other way, but the referee decides it is a foul on Nikhil Pujari. Still playing his club football at Hyderabad, but there have been rumblings and rumours that he might be moving on in the January transfer window. Change about to be made by Uzbekistan. It's an India free kick though. Brandon Fernandes is over it. Keeps it away from the goalkeeper, but keeps it away from the blue shirts in the area as well. Too much on it. Change about to be made as well by Uzbekistan. Boltaboyev and Iskandarov are going to come on. Pandita have a good enough close control. That's a lovely ball into space for Irkanov, the substitute. There's only one player in the middle. Sergeyev might have to go on his own. It's a heavy touch and puts the ball out for a goal kick. It's a good idea. And a good move down that far side, Erkinov, who's got plenty of pace. Here comes the change, or the changes. Fazuliev, who scored that first goal, is going off to be replaced by Iskandarov. And also going off is Hamramikov to be replaced by Boltaboyev, who makes just a third appearance. Boltaboyev can play in a number of positions, either in defence or midfield. Boltaboyev, who played at the 2012 under-16 AFC Championships, went training at AS Monaco's academy after that. Have made all five changes now, just three made by Igor Stimac, but could well be another couple coming up in a moment. So offside against Snerum, who was coming back from an offside position. Don't think there'll be a huge amount of added time to go on here at the end of the game. We've had no VAR interventions tonight as yet, no goals in the second half, and very few injuries, to be honest, as well. I don't remember the trainers coming on in the second half at all for any injuries. We've gone from one extreme to the other in some of the games. Of course, the referee's now adding on time to make sure that the ball stays in play for its maximum. We had, 14 minutes, I think, a couple of nights ago. Foul there by Deepak Tangri. There from Raul Beke. Yeah. Making another change. Adanta coming on to replace Naram Mahesh. Deepak Tangri came on for Suresh Wangchan, by the way. Adanta, who had spent all his career at Bengaluru before moving to FC Goa ahead of the current Indian Super League season. To Uzbekistan, it'll be Iskandarov, who only came on a few moments ago, that will take this one. Biggest win in this competition so far this year is 4-0, Jordan beating Malaysia a few nights ago. Can Uzbekistan match that in the minutes that remain here? 4 minutes plus stoppage time. Free header away from Ishan Pandita. From Akash Mishra, who took a knock on the back of the head. Skandarov, I think it was, with the challenge. Again, another player that's just come on. That was Turgenboyev, who's caught him. Well, they haven't stopped singing, they haven't stopped banging the drums, and they haven't stopped making noise all night, those Uzbekistan fans, and they will celebrate victory here. The Indian fans won't be too despondent. There were some great pictures on social media of the India fans in the souk down in Doha yesterday and last night, just creating a really good atmosphere and indicative of everything that's going on around this tournament. But Uzbekistan will go 4 points. Australia, don't forget, top the group after their second win today against Syria. Sanesh Jinga. Mishra. Tangri. Had a good game in that first game against Australia, given a specific job to do by Igor Stimac. Probably one of the surprise inclusions in the India squad for this tournament. One of the uncapped players, plays his football for Mohun Bagan. Another foul by Turgenboyev. Mishra on the receiving end once again. He got a bang on the head a moment or so ago, and now he's had his head cut trodden on by Turgenboyev. Brandon Fernandes with the free kick. Can India get a consolation? Runners. Yusupov, a good clean take that time, the goalkeeper. Hasn't had too much to do between the posts. Shots on target for India tonight, which is slightly better than they managed in their opening game. He Iskandarov. Sifiev. Clumsy challenge from Nikhil Pujari, which was double teamed there by Pujari and Deepak Tangri. Lukanov gets a free kick here in a dangerous position. Here comes the added time. Just 5 minutes to be added on at the end of the 90. Probably one of the lowest stoppage times we've had, I think, throughout this tournament so far. Well, the minimum that Uzbekistan would have hoped for would be a place in the round of 16 to match what they did in the UAE. It looks as though this will give them a almost guarantee them a place in the next round. Into the danger area, headed over by Boltabayev. Last time India and Uzbekistan met was back in 2001. Uzbekistan won 2-1. They had a 2-2 draw in 1997, but all the other win games, three of them have all gone the way of Uzbekistan. Had that tonight as well. Vedanta. Deepak Tangri. Ralbeke. Sanders Jinger. Just seeing out time now, Uzbekistan. Well, that's given away. Ishan Pandita. Can he capitalise this time? Takes the ball out wide. Good recovery, though, from Huzanov. Probably the only mistake he's made all night. But again, Pandita's lack of pace just letting him down as he tried to burst beyond those two central defenders. Mishra, one of those changes for India tonight, coming in for Subhashish Bose. It's a shooting shot off on the side of the bar from Iskandarov. Had a good sight at goal and got plenty of pace on that, but Gurpreet rooted to the spot, but just a fraction too high. Rattles the frame. Tender for one of the goals of the tournament, so that one found its way in. Sifiev. Ismudarov. Yusupov, Ishmudarov. It's Iskandarov, when he hit the bar a moment or so ago. Safiev getting forward once again. He's looked good since swapping sides after Nazrulov. Nazruliev went off earlier on at half-time. Shukrov. It's been a good all-round performance by Uzbekistan. Abduraktov. Husanov. Well, the referee brings the game to a close a few seconds early, but it is job done for Uzbekistan, and India suffer their second defeat of this AFC Asian Cup here in Qatar 2023. Igor Stimac and Srechko Katanic shaking hands with each other, but there's the top story. Fazuliev getting the goal after 4 minutes, Sugiev 21 minutes, and then deep into added time, the left-back Nazruliev finding himself in space in the box to fire beyond Gurpreet and really put the game beyond India at the halfway point. Uzbekistan came out in the second half, they knew they didn't have to press too hard. India had chances, they hit the bar, they forced Yusupov into a couple of saves, but in the end it was Uzbekistan who held firm to keep their goal intact. India still looking for their first goal in their two matches as well. Even the introduction of Raul KP in the second half couldn't help them adding that little bit of pace into the India side. Apoya worked hard, but Uzbekistan were just a class above India tonight here at the Ahmed Bin Ali Stadium, which is a dramatic sight at night, as you can see. But the lights here will be going out soon. But it is Uzbekistan that take the points. It's finished. India 0, Uzbekistan 3.